All right, Chike, so for example, when we have the equation x plus 3 all of it squared minus 4 equals 0, and our goal in this case, guys, is to actually solve for x. So we want to go ahead and solve for x here. The goal in this case, once again, is to actually isolate the variable, move everything on one side. So let's go ahead and do that, guys. Starting off, first thing I want to go ahead and move is that negative 4 that I have. I'm actually going to go ahead and do the opposite and add 4 to both sides. This cancels what I have on my left-hand side. And I'm left with x plus a 3 squared equals 4. Now, my next step in this case, guys, is I actually have a squared. Now, I need to get rid of the squared. And in order to do that, I need to do the opposite. Now, the opposite of a squared, guys, is actually the square root. So I'm going to go ahead and take the square root of both sides. Now, on my left-hand side, guys, this actually cancels both the squared and the square root. And I'm left with x plus 3. Equals in this case a plus or minus 2. Now once again, this is an equation, guys, so whenever you're solving for the x, in this case, for example, if you were to have x squared equal to 4, then you could actually have two solutions here. You could either have a positive 2 being squared or a negative 2 being squared. So that's where we get the two solutions from. All right, now in this case, guys, from here I want to go ahead and add I want to go ahead and create two separate equations. One of them is going to contain our positive 2, and the other one is going to contain the negative 2. All right, and these are simple two-step equations, guys. I'm going to go ahead and subtract 2 to both sides, and we have x in this case is equal to a negative 1, and then on the other side, I'm going to go ahead and subtract 3 as well. And in this case, guys, x is going to be equal to negative 5. Now we have x is equal to negative 1 or x is equal to negative 5, guys. And in this case, these represent our x-intercepts. X-intercepts, that's what they represent here.